When it came time to Glass Houses, that was around 1980, and we were playing, we had now had about 2-3 years of playing in arenas and coliseums, and I recognized that I needed to write bigger music. Songs like Just the Way You Are, Honesty, ballads, they don't always fly that well in an arena. You need big sound. So I started writing harder edge songs, more guitar-based songs, sometimes a fantasy, Still Rock and Roll to Me, You May Be Right, Close to the Borderline, All for Lena. And it was fun to do. This was probably the most fun album that I ever made. It happened fairly quickly. The band loved playing it. Audiences loved the material that was on the recording. And we were on a roll. Instead of just playing an acoustic piano, I was playing all different kinds of electric pianos to kind of get it at a harder edge. Around 1980, there was the Yamaha CP80, and it just had a good punch to it, just really good bang, you know, on the piano. And you could throw it really good, too. I threw it off the stage a few times. It made an impression. That's actually the house I was living in at the time, which is right near Teddy Roosevelt's house in Oyster Bay. And I saw the photo and I said, you know, people who live in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. And that's, the name stuck, Glass Houses. I said, that works. And as a matter of fact, the beginning of the album, you hear a glass being shattered, which is the picture on the back. They noticed the bike, the guy who was shooting the picture. They just had asked if they could take a shot of me on the bike. And I said, okay, sure. I was very comfortable with the motorcycle. Again, it's one of those prop things. I got a rock in my hand. There's a trumpet over here. I'm leaning on a pillow here. I'm holding the turnstiles here. I got to do something with my hands. I can't just, you know, I don't know what my hands feel like, huge clown hands.